Well, I have some questions here, and if one, some of the questions here provoke another question, we should bring it up, and we'll ask it as well, amen? First question to anyone on the panel. How does a reform perspective uniquely address justice in our cities and our neighborhoods? I think your name is all of them.
So how does a reform perspective uniquely address justice issues? First, thank you for pulling this together and having us here again for the conference, for your leadership in that, and for the church and its leadership and kindness and hosting us. All this feed us real good. And then you're gonna ask us questions after lunch. I don't know what I'm about to say. If there are uniquenesses to a reformed view of justice issues, then perhaps it's unique in its stress on biblical definitions of justice. Mm-hmm. Understand the centrality of Scripture, the authority and sufficiency of Scripture for working through these types of issues. And perhaps it's unique for its emphasis on the sovereignty of God and the sort of long arc of justice. So that if we hold to a reformed life and world view, that means at least two things. We can engage the sometimes messy, complex issues of injustice or justice in the world, A, the plumb line, the Bible itself. And that helps us because in many of the justice issues that we're looking at are things that are being called justice. There are a lot of, I would say there are a lot of sort of immoralities attaching themselves to justice issues, right? And so you don't have to look far to see that. So the push over the last several years for same-sex marriage has been billed as kind of the new black and the sort of next evolution of the civil rights movement. Right now, sort of Black Lives hashtag has been, Black Lives Matter hashtag has been expanded to say all Black Lives Matter. And specifically, in some instances, they're talking about transgender lives. And so at that point, you get a blurring of the lines, but the Bible helps us with that in knowing right and wrong, in knowing moral and immoral, and drawing some distinctions between these things, affirming good and eschewing the bad. And we can do this because God is sovereign without a sort of creeping sense of despair and a creeping sense that we're losing. We're not. And much of the evangelical world right now feels itself reeling in the aftermath of some major Supreme Court decisions and things of that sort. Feels itself reeling as if it's losing the war. Our war has never been, honestly, to win the culture. That is not justice for us. We are most concerned about the justice of God in judgment and in salvation. And so, you know, these things, if we receive them as medicine, if we receive them as corrections, get us back to thinking about biblical justice without the blinding, entangling effects of privilege and status. So Christians lose status and privilege in the sort of culture of the country. You know, I think that's going to tend toward a sanctifying, purifying effect on the local church, and it's probably going to help us think more carefully when our Bible's open about what justice is.